Hello my dear students, welcome back to study English grammar. I just want you to remember what all you learnt in your previous classes. In this video, let me teach you the parts of speech. They are also called as word class. In traditional grammar, a part of speech is a category of word that have similar grammatical properties. They are also called word class. In your course book, the first lesson, in the exercise part, you have an exercise on word class. Remember, how many parts of speech are there? You can watch on your screen. There are 8 parts of speech, and they are noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Now let us learn one by one. What is noun? It's a naming word. Namapada anta heltivi. It's a word that names a person, place, animal or a thing. Example, Nagaraj, Parvati, lion, bag, stone, boy. There are various types of nouns. How many types of nouns are there? 5 types. Common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun and material noun. In some of the grammar books, you find only 4 types. Common, proper, collective, abstract. Some others, 5. First one is common noun. What is a common noun? It's a noun that refers to a class of entities. It refers to a non-specific person, place or thing. Example, tiger, girl, boy, people, mother, father, etc. They are called as common noun. Proper noun. It's a noun that identifies a single entity or a specific person, place or a thing. ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಅವನದೇ ಆದಂಥ ಹೆಸರನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವಿ, ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಅದರದೇ ಆದಂಥ ಹೆಸರನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವಿ, ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗೆ ಅದರದೇ ಆದಂಥ ಒಂದು ಹೆಸರನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ನೌನ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಆಗಲೇ ನಾವು ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ, ಕಾಮನ್ ನೌನಿಗೆ ಬಾಯ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಬಾಯ್, ವರುಣ್. ಆಗಲೇ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ ಅಥವಾ ವುಮನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ, ಕಾಮನ್ ನೌನ್. ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ನೌನ್, ಹರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ವಿಮಲಾ. The name of the place, Bangalore, Ulahannur, etc. They are all called as proper nouns. Next, the third one is collective noun. It is a noun that refers to the collection of things, animals or even people. I have given a few examples here. A bunch of grapes, a bunch of keys, an army of soldiers, school of fish, a band of robbers, a choir of singers, a cup of tea, a bowl of rice. They are called as collective noun. A bunch annado gumpanna suchustade, army annado gumpanna suchustade, choir annado gumpanna suchustade. Hagadre they are called as collective nouns. Next, abstract noun. A noun that cannot be explained but experienced. ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ನೌನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಸಾಧ್ಯ, ವಿವರಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಸಾಧ್ಯ, ಆದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಅನುಭವಿಸ್ಬೋದು, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಡ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ವಿಸ್ಡಮ್, ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್, ಲವ್, ಹೆಟ್ರೆಡ್, ಸ್ಯಾಡ್ನೆಸ್, ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್, ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ, ಬ್ರೇವರಿ, ಚಾರಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ abstract noun. And the last one is material noun. What is material noun? A noun that refers to the things or substance from which things are made, such as silver, gold, iron, cotton, diamond and plastic. Examples are, you can watch on your screen, aluminium, coal, copper, gold, iron, calcium, cotton, cloth, diamond, meat, flour, glass, marble, platinum, plastic, milk, paper, wood, wool, silver, they are all called as material nouns. So remember, there are 5 types of nouns. Now let us move on to the gender. Gender andre linga. When we speak about noun, we must remember this also. There are 3 genders: masculine gender, feminine gender, neuter gender. I have given some examples. For masculine gender, man, he; feminine, woman, she; neuter, child. Then you have number, singular or plural. ಏಕವಚನಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಬಹುವಚನಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಗಿವನ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್: ಬುಕ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್, ಪ್ಲೂರಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್. ಬ್ಯಾಗ್, ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್. ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ, ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋಸ್. ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 2 ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಬುಕ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್, ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಎಸ್. ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ವರ್ಡ್, ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಓವಲ್ ಓ, so you have to add es there. Mangoes. Tomato, tomatoes. Some of the words change their form themselves while making it as plural. For example, man becomes men, woman women, child children. So my dear children, you can do one homework for this. You select some nouns from your course book. Find out whether they are singular. If they are singular, find the plural form of the words and write 10 of them and send me through WhatsApp. Next, you have cases. There are 5 cases in English. Nominative case, vocative case, genitive case, dative case, accusative case. I have given one example. Nominative case, usually you have it in the subject part of the sentence. For example, Ramesh. Ramesh is nominative case. Look at the example. Ramesh is a doctor. In this sentence, Ramesh is the subject of the sentence, so it is in the nominative case. Vocative case, again, after Ramesh, if you place a comma, that means to say someone is calling Ramesh. So here Ramesh becomes vocative case. So example is, Ramesh, come here. Genitive case, you find there Ramesh apostrophe S. That means something belongs to Ramesh. It is called as genitive case. Example, it is Ramesh's book. Dative case. Dative case means if you add the word to a noun in order to mean that you are handing over something to someone else, then it becomes dative case. Look at the example. The book was given to Ramesh. Whom was the book given? Yes, it was given to Ramesh. And the last case is accusative case. Again, you find in a sentence, the object part of the sentence is called as accusative case. For example, she called Ramesh. Now she is the nominative case and Ramesh is in the accusative case. And dear students, till now you learned 8 parts of speech, and the first one, noun and the types of nouns. Now you take down the questions and answer them. First one is, how many parts of speech are there? Second one, what is a noun? Third, name the types of nouns with 2 examples each. Fourth question, read the first lesson select some nouns there which may be in singular or plural. If they are singular, write the plural of the noun. If they are plural, write the singular of the noun. Let us meet in the next video and continue learning about the other parts of speech.